If you store data in BigQuery, you might find that you want to get it into Tinybird. Maybe you want to enrich event streams with dimensional data that you have in BigQuery tables or something like that. Well, syncing BigQuery to Tinybird is very easy with the Tinybird BigQuery Connector. In this screencast, I'll show you how to import and sync BigQuery data into Tinybird using both the UI and the CLI. Let's go. Okay, let's start in the UI, and it's like creating any other data source in Tinybird. You click that little plus icon and find BigQuery. When you click BigQuery, a unique Google Cloud Service account principle will be created for your Tinybird workspace. You need to give that account permission to view data in your BigQuery tables. To do that, first, copy the principle in the UI, then log into your Google Cloud Platform console as a project editor, and navigate to IAM and Admin. Click Grant Access, paste the principle, assign the role of BigQuery Data Viewer, and then click Save. This will give your Tinybird workspace read access to your BigQuery tables. So go ahead and click Next to choose your data. Now you'll see the BigQuery projects, datasets, and tables you have access to in a clickable table tree. And you can go ahead and select the table you want to import and click Next. Now you'll create a sync schedule for your BigQuery table. Now, you can do this by simply selecting a schedule in the basic view, or if you want a little more control, you can click the Advanced tab and set the schedule based on a cron expression. You'll also select your import strategy here. Replace data will sync the data source to match your BigQuery table by replacing all the rows with the current data in BigQuery table, while append data will incrementally ingest new rows that have been added to your BigQuery table since the last sync. Okay, now click Next again, and then you'll see a preview of the data in that BigQuery table. Here's where you can define your data source details. So go ahead and give it a name and a description, and then click Create Data Source. And that's it. You'll see the data source is being provisioned, and the first sync will happen at the next timestamp that matches the cron expression you set in the scheduling step. Note that if you'd like to sync your BigQuery table into Tinybird on demand, you can always click the Sync Now button. Now, when you view a data source created using the BigQuery connector, you'll see a sync timeline up here at the top, so you can track your syncs and see if any of the jobs failed. If you want to pause the schedule, you can click Pause Sync and resume it whenever you're ready. So that's the UI. Now, let's see how to sync a BigQuery table into Tinybird using the CLI. Now, if you haven't already, go ahead and authenticate to your workspace with tbauth. Next, you'll want to set up the BigQuery connection for your workspace, just like we did in the UI. To do that in the CLI, you'll type tb connection create BigQuery. You'll see a prompt to copy the principle and add it to your GCP account as a BigQuery data viewer, just like we did in the UI walkthrough. Now, after you've done that, you can proceed, and you should get a response saying your BigQuery connection was created successfully. Now, as with any other Tinybird data source, a data source created from a BigQuery table can be defined in a .datasource file. So let's create that .datasource file. Now, if you're starting from scratch, you'll need to define the data source schema in the file. But for the sake of time, I've copied down a data source schema so we can just walk through how to connect it to BigQuery. So down below the schema, you'll add import underscore service BigQuery. This indicates you're using the Tinybird BigQuery connector. Then you'll define your schedule with import underscore schedule and that cron expression. Next, you'll define your import strategy with import underscore strategy and the ingestion strategy you're using, in this case, replace. And finally, your import query with import underscore query and the query to select from that BigQuery table. And then once you save that file, you can push it to the server with tbpush and the file name. And if you hop over into the UI, you'll see you have a new BigQuery data source. And that's it, we're done. Now, if you have any more questions about the BigQuery connector, or if you'd like more info on the Tinybird connector development kit or any future connectors, you can always find us in Slack. If you're watching on YouTube, I've linked to join our Slack community below. Thanks, talk to you soon.